yourself in to the Magic Bay as well. Please get all media.
You know, you've been champion. You've been champion. You got the big house. So are you going to be as hungry to get back to the top as you were getting there in the first place?
Yeah, definitely. At the end of the day, I have a passion for the sport of boxing. I love boxing.
Coming out.
I love the competition. That's what motivates me. That's what we made
to see back the way on Friday. Final press conference tomorrow.
What do you think? Do you think critics have a point when they say that Rios' health might even be in trouble in this fight because of the wars he's been in and the kind of fighter in yourself that he's going up against?
I can't worry about none of that stuff. At the end of the day, I know he traded his heart out for this fight. It's an opportunity of a lifetime for him. It's a big fight for me. I have to go in there and show the world I'm still one of the best fighters in the world. And that's basically it. I can't worry about, you know, his health or anything. I just got to go in there and beat Danny Garcia.
It's been a little while since you've been here in Vegas, but you've had two of your biggest wins in Matisse and Amir Khan. How does it feel to be back here?
Oh, it feels great. This is Vegas is like the atmosphere, like the big fight atmosphere, and it motivates me. I feel good. I'm motivated again, and I just can't wait to go in there and fight.
Danny, you see this as an inside fight, and you're fighting against Brandon Rios, because he said he hopes that you're going to stand right in front of him, because you usually do.
It depends how I feel. It depends how I feel, but it could be an inside fight. I'm going to do a little bit of everything, baby. I'm a bang, I'm a box, I'm a back, I'm back came up, I'm a fight backing up, I'm gonna do everything, whatever it takes for me to win, I'm gonna do it.
You have a goal on how early you wanna knock him out, or does it matter what?
Shit, if it was my pick, I'd try first round everybody, get that check and I'm gone, but yeah, okay. 12 rounds or less, baby. I would like to get it done under 8, under 6 rounds, but if not, I'm ready for 12 rounds. I had a great camp, we trained hard.
Hey, Danny, how do you feel the fact that all the champions, they're willing to throw you all the way to the front of the line and give you a shot at the title? Does that mean you're going to be fighting for a title?
That's because I'm the biggest name.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they want that name. But at the end of the day, I have to worry about Saturday night. Mm-hmm. But all those fights are going to be there. After this fight, all those fights are going to be there. And they're going to be there for about the next year, year and a half.
I know you want that Keith Thurman rematch bad, but it seems like he kind of wants to take his time before he gets back to the big fights. What do you think about that?
I don't blame him. Shit, I don't blame him. I wouldn't want to fight me 2 times in a row. But, you know, it is what it is. Like I said before, my journey and my superstardom starts again Saturday night. And my job is to show the world why I'm still one of the best superstars in the sport.
You're still young anyway, so I mean, there's time to get to that fight.
Exactly. I'm 29 years old. I feel good. I'm in the prime of my career. And like I said before, it starts here. This is a big fight for me to get back on track and get my claim back to the top.
You're representing Philadelphia again. You represent them wherever you go, but you're out west now. What are you going to do for Philly?
Oh, I'm representing Philly everywhere I go. I represent Philly. I represent all the Latinos. I represent everybody around the world. So when you're a world champion boxer, you know, and you did it 3 times, you represent everybody in the world. I have fans all over the world, so I know they expect excited to see me fight.
You see yourself fighting for a title this year, Danny, or next year?
It's possible. It's possible, but I don't know. I just gotta take one fight at a time.
How many times you gonna fight this year?
Two times this year. Danny, just one and another one.
Do you feel like Brandon's style is perfect for the kind of way you fight for to make you look good?
That's okay.
Yeah. Yeah, he likes to bang. Shit. You want to stand in front of me? Hey, let's do it. Shit.
When the crowd gets into it, when you guys are there toe to toe, is it hard to not just bang with them just because you know they're kind of.
Well, if I feel I'm the stronger man, I'm definitely not going to back up. If I'm the stronger man, there's no need for me to back up. You know, I'm just going to get the job done. That's it.
I'm sure you believe you are the stronger man?
Yes, sir.
How long does it usually take you to figure that out?
Probably about two or four rounds.
Yeah. So you see around there, then you'll feel that if you can push it.
Usually, like, fighters get weak after, like, the fourth round. Like, when I fought Thurman, he didn't have no power after the fourth round.
Really?
Yeah, it was gone.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
how big of a difference was it from the first?
It was a big difference. He was strong in the first couple, but after that, he wasn't really strong no more. I was a stronger man. I was chasing him down.
I was going to make another observation. It seems like you filled out more at 47 compared to a year ago.
Yeah.
How do you feel now?
Definitely. You got to understand, when I went into the welterweight division, my second fight was for a world title, and then I unified it right after that. So I only had like 2 or 3 fights. I went in there and tried to depot the welterweight division. But, you know, like I said before, I'm back, man. And I'm feeling better than ever, but I definitely feel like I filled into my weight. I feel Because usually when I get on the scale, I look small for being at that weight. But now I look actually bigger. So I feel good.
Danny, it seems like with your dad, he's not just your father and your trainer, but you guys are friends. Like, yeah. He's your best friend. Can you talk about that a little
bit? We're going to the strip club after the fight. We're going to Girl Collection.
Girl Collection.
Yeah, that's where we're going.
Girl Collection. You got to
plug it in. Mayweather's Club. Girl Collection. Right after the fight. Yeah.
But why do you guys think, why do you think that is? That it's not just the father-son thing, that you guys like hanging around each other. You got, like, almost a friendship on top of it.
It's better that way because when you're just a father, you feel like you can't tell your father everything. You can't tell him bad things, and you can't tell him certain things, you know what I mean? You'll tell your friend before you tell your dad because you're scared to tell him. So me and my father have a relationship where we can tell each other anything. If it's going to hurt our feelings or not, we still have that understanding where, we're friends and he's my father. We're always going to figure it out.
Does it get you mad when people go against him, like in the media or fans?
At the end of the day, he asked for that, so he got to fight. So he know what he does. So when you say something, you gotta deal with the backlash. You gotta deal with it. So it is what it is. He's a man of his word, and he sticks by it.
Is it ever a struggle to kind of not the lines are blurred, or ever like, no, Dad, I don't want to do this. Like, is it ever sort of like that way?
Because what do you mean? Like when
dad,
he says something?
Yeah, when he tells you things, and you're like, shut up, Dad, no.
Oh, when he tells me to do
yeah.
things.
Yeah, kids can be like that.
Yeah, that's every day. Yeah, it's every day.
Yeah,
it's every day. We just regular like anybody else. Mm-hmm. And some days I don't feel like doing something, and some days he don't want to do something.
Yeah,
man, that's just how things work.
But overall, you think it's worked right because of the mutual respect, or is there something else?
No, I think it's just deeper than that. To be real, it's deeper. When you come from nothing with somebody, it's different. You know what I'm saying? When you become successful, then you bring another trainer in, it's never gonna be the same because me and him came from the bottom, so we have to understand that we know where we come from. And that's why we always gonna respect each other because we know how far we came.
Has there ever been a moment where you were like, man, Dad, you went too far. That was a little too crazy.
A couple times, but he does that. A couple times, I don't go lie. I was like, yo, you crazy guy, bro. We about to fight him before.
Yeah.
But, yeah, man, Pops is Pops. He's from North Philly. He's straight old school, so he just tell her how it is. And that's basically how it is. I'm not like that. I'm the type of person, I just be like, shit, like, I let things slide. Like, I don't care, but not him. Thinking that nothing slide.
All right. What can the fans expect Saturday night?
A spectacular performance by Danny Garcia.
Thanks, Danny.